KiCad 8 is now available. I've been using the nightly builds on a small project for several weeks, and just like version 6 and 7 before it, the development team has added a bunch of new stuff. The list is very long, whether you look at the GitLab closed issues or even the condensed KiCad 8 release blog. That being the case, I picked 8 things, for obvious reasons, that I thought were interesting. The biggest change I am happy to see is the property manager is now in the schematic editor. You can click on an element and change most of its properties without opening a separate dialog. And as an added bonus, the symbol and footprint editors also have it now too. Finally, the NextGrid hotkey issue with the schematic editor has been fixed. One time I opened the schematic someone else made for the BitPreserve project, and ERC had a ton of off-grid warnings. This problem happens when the grid becomes something other than 50 mil or 1.27 millimeter. For example, in previous versions, hitting the N hotkey toggled the grid, and 1 or 2 mils were a big no-no. This was super easy to hit by accident because it is right next to the M or move hotkey. One improvement is there is now a pop-up when you hit the hotkey. On the KiCad GitLab issue discussing this issue, there was a long discussion. The solution is to have grid overrides for certain operations. For example, when I move a part around, it is fixed to a 50 mil grid regardless of the current grid setting. But when I move its text designator, it is on a much finer grid. Schematic symbols have supported alternate pin functions for a long time, but until version 8, they were very cumbersome to use. For example, on this flash chip, the pins can be either a SPI or quad SPI interface. Instead of naming the pin with both functions, you can give each pin an alternate assignment in the symbol editor. Once that happens, now you can just right-click in the schematic editor and change its function quickly. If you cannot select just the pin, then you need to go to Preferences, Preferences, Schematic Editor, Editing Options, and unselect, clicking a pin selects the symbol. Now, it will work. And by the way, just like older versions, you can edit the properties and go to the pin functions table to make mass updates. Related to pins, I saw this one in the version 8 announcement, and even though it means I have to cheat on the list later, I had to add this one. If you select only the pins of a symbol, then you can select some pin helpers. These let you quickly add wires or labels. This is an alternate to using the repeat last function or insert key shortcut. Also, the labels automatically populate with the names of the pins. Just like before, if you're unable to select only the pins, make sure you unselect the preference from the last tip. Also, there are 2 ways to select objects in KiCad. If you click then drag to the left, any object inside of the selection box gets selected. Notice how the pins and the symbol are selected here. However, if you click and then drag to the right, only the objects completely inside of the selection box get selected. So this time the symbol didn't get selected since the entire symbol did not fit within the selection box. And then this time, everything fit. Since we changed this copy of the symbol earlier, if you click on it and then go to inspect, you can compare the symbol to the library version. This visual tool lets you see how it changed. Until version 8, in order to create power symbols, you had to create a part in the library, which is what I had to do on this schematic originally. Now, it is as simple as just editing an existing power symbol, and suddenly you can have a custom power net. This is a somewhat small change, but it helps streamline when working with multiple power rails. One caution, however, is that currently ERC will not catch it if you name them with different capitalizations. This is unlike net labels, which will generate a warning. I've already submitted a feature request for this, so I'll put a link below if you want to follow its progress. I'm counting these next 2 features as one because I feel like they're heavily related. They help with navigating large schematics. The search box contains a list of symbols, text objects, and labels across multiple sheets. The Symbols tab is similar to the Edit Symbols table, but you cannot edit any of the fields here. The Labels tab is a good way to see what labels exist across pages, especially in schematics that do not use many wires. Adding the Net Navigator can give you a tree view of a net's flow throughout the design. For example, bit 7 of the data bus is an important bit in 6502 designs. And in this case, there are multiple instances on page 2. Using these tools, we can see where else in the design this net connects to without even having to leave the sheet. Over in PCB, there are a couple of shape-related changes that I'm very happy to see. First, let's draw a funky polygon. If you place it on a copper layer, you can now assign it to a net. By the way, did you know that these net name dropdowns are actually filters? Next, there are modification tools for polygons like rectangles that let you add fillets and chamfers. Chamfers? Fillets? I don't know, they're mechanical terms. Anyway, they allow you to have nice looking corners. So now it should be much easier to make rounded corners for your PCB. You can even fillet the funky polygon too. But when you do, it gets converted into individual segments, so you'll need to create a polygon from selection to turn it back into a filled shape, if that's what you want to do. Okay, these last two are where I'm cheating a little bit because they're really two separate features, but I'm combining them as one because I haven't used them much yet. In board setup, there is now built-in support for teardrops. Google tells me that these can help improve manufacturability of your PCB. To add them to a design, use the Edit Teardrops tool. This tool works like the other mass editing tools with a scope, filter, and action. The teardrops follow the zone fill setting, so if you just see lines around your connection, turn on zone fill. Another significant feature is the length tuning patterns. The KiCad team continues to work on improving this functionality, and frankly, I don't have a demo for this yet, but I am looking forward to testing these changes out in the very near future. Okay, so I covered more than 8 because I couldn't help it. There's a lot of really good stuff in this update, especially for the schematic editor. Let me know what your favorite version 8 features are in the comments below. In the description, I'll put a link to the announcement blog because I didn't cover everything that they covered over there. All right, so now that version 8 is out, can we start asking when version 9 is coming?